The fate of this courageous woman still excites and admires many people. It's Ukrainian poetess and publicist Olena Teliha. She was Ukrainian in spirit and origin, although she was born in Russia. For a long time, she spoke Russian. Being a romantic nationalist, she wrote lyrical verses and at the same time was an extremely strong-willed figure and invincible fighter. Olena Teliha knew what wealth was, and even poverty didn't break her. She dreamed of a long, happy life in her native Ukraine, but she gave her life for it. She believed that her poetry would live long in the hearts of future generations, but she wasn't remembered for nearly 50 years since her name was not in line with Soviet history. She was one of many, and at the same time, she was only and unique. She was unique in her own way, and in some ways her fate is similar to that of other women. After all, every feat, every death, let's say so, it unites those who were brave, did not betray, and went to the limit upholding their views. In spring of 2017, Appreciative Kyivans opened a monument to the poetess and outstanding figure of the National Liberation Movement. It was established on the territory of the Babi Yar National Historical Memorial Reserve. It was the place where, in February of 1942, Olena Teliha was shot by fascists. The future poetess spent her childhood outside Ukraine. She was born in the Moscow region in the summer of 1907. Her father, Ivan Afanasyevich Shavganov, was a hydraulic engineer and famous scientist who taught at the Moscow Engineering School. Young Olena learned about Ukraine from her mother, who was from the Podila region. Before the revolutionary events of 1917, Olena moved with her family to Kyiv. Engineer Ivan Shavganov was invited to teach at the Kyiv Polytechnic Institute, and then he worked in the Ministry of Railways of the Ukrainian People's Republic government. Olena studied at a Kyiv gymnasium. She studied Ukrainian along with the Russian, German, and French languages. After the fall of several Ukrainian governments in 1918-1920, those who supported them became outcasts. Among them were many military men and Ukrainian national intellectuals.
Якщо говорити про еміграцію з України періоду 1917-20-х років, так, то це
In the context of the 1917-1920s immigration, it was a completely different period when Ukrainians fled because they mainly opposed changes to the political system. They also opposed the establishment of Soviet power, and then well-educated people, representatives of Ukrainian intelligentsia or wealthy people, found themselves overseas and in Europe. Among those who fled were many artists. It is interesting that at that time, many Ukrainian patriots supporting the Ukrainian People's Republic and the national liberation struggle immigrated from Ukraine. But they had no choice but to leave their homeland.
Було багато патріотів українців, які підтримували Українську Народну Республіку, національно-визвольні змагання, і які змушені були залишити батьківщину.
Олена's father was also in this stream of political immigrants. Later, his wife and children, Олена with her brother, who escaped from Soviet Ukraine, joined him. Many who left their homeland considered the struggle for Ukraine's independence the meaning of their entire life. To be closer to their homeland, they settled in Poland or Czechoslovakia. After uniting the Shavganov family, also settled in the city of Podibrady in the present Czech Republic. Czechs' human attitude towards immigrants, giving them the opportunity to freely receive education, turned Czechoslovakia into the main center of Ukrainian political immigration and Ukrainian culture.
Взагалі, ми не можемо, мабуть, знайти у світі такого подібного.
There is no other historical case when cultural literature and art developed in parallel in both mainland Ukraine and beyond its borders. And it turned out that the foreign or immigration component was extremely large and it was also extremely fruitful and rich.
Зарубіжний еміграційний є надзвичайно великий і надзвичайно плідний і багатий.
With funds provided by the Czech government, a higher educational establishment, the Ukrainian Economic Academy, was established in Podibrady. Olena's father became the rector of this university. Here she entered the environment of young Ukrainian poets and intellectuals. In 1923, she received a certificate of secondary education and in the same year she entered the historical and philological faculty of the M.P. Dragomanov Ukrainian Pedagogical Institute in Prague. In her student years, Olena Shevgenova met her future husband, Mikhailo Teliha, who was a Cuban Cossack, a bandura player, and a leader of the UPR army. In August of 1926, they married. Starting in the institute, Olena began her literary career publishing many Ukrainian immigration literary editions. It was in Prague where she became a poetess, publicist, literary critic, and Ukrainian patriot. There, in Prague, she reflected on her inner man. She had very close contacts with representatives of the Prague school. They also deeply influenced her, although she was just beginning her poetic path. She could not yet enter the group of those eminent poets of note with their system of image thinking. There were outstanding poets who were published in Western Ukraine in Lviv.
Це були вже видатні постаті поети, які друкувалися активно в Західній Україні, у Львові.
After graduating from the Prague University in 1929, Olena Teliha moved with her husband to Warsaw. They found it difficult to live in a new place. Sometimes they had to appear with musical performances in night cabarets. Then she began to work as a teacher in a Ukrainian school and continued creative and social activities. Olena became a staff author of the Lviv magazine «Вісник», which was published by a theoretician and ideologist of Ukrainian nationalism, Dmytro Donsov, in the 1930s. She also appeared with abstracts and poems during literary discussions and other events that took place among representatives of Ukrainian immigration. Her poetry was full of deep patriotic feelings and thirst for the struggle for Ukraine. There was also a desire to awaken indifferent people, to find like-minded people, and to act together. And she found them. In 1939, in Krakow, Olena met Ukrainian poet, head of the Cultural and Educational Office of Ukrainian Nationalists, Oleg Olzhich.
Головна мета організації українських націоналістів, незважаючи на обставини, була одна – відновлення української держави.
Ukrainian nationalists, despite the circumstances, aimed at restoring the Ukrainian state. And Ukrainians, using the war, wanted to do the same. They considered Slovakia and Croatia, formed as a result of the military operations, to be such an example. Having all the grounds for this, they hoped to implement it. Preparing for the campaign in Ukraine, the government planning commission was established to develop new legislation for the future new Ukraine. There was everything from the constitution to the act of establishing a monetary unit, the hryvnia. All that was left was to put the date to the above act.
Актом про встановлення грошової одиниці гривні. В тому акті залишалось поставити тільки дату.
Олена Теліха readily joined the Ukrainian nationalist movement.
І вона включилася в цю боротьбу, вона стала членом.
And she joined this struggle. She became a member of the cultural office headed by Oleg Olzhich. Olena worked hard in this area. She prepared leaflets, trained staff of those people who had to go on marches in groups in Ukraine. In hopes of liberating and reviving independent Ukraine, Olena Teliha returned to Kyiv with one of such marship groups in October 1941. She was waiting for this chance to see Kyiv. She really dreamed of seeing that Kyiv, which she could only dream of and think about while living in abroad and in Prague. This was because she was just a young girl when she left Ukraine. She considered Kyiv amazingly festive and solemn. It was really so at the time. It was October. Chestnut trees were yellow, everything was so sunny, although undoubtedly there was already devastation, and it was seen that occupiers had already ruled there. In Kyiv, Olena Teliha immediately started to arrange a literary life. She headed the Union of Ukrainian Writers and edited the literary almanac Litari. This was the supplement to the newspaper The Ukrainian Word. They set a goal to revive Ukrainian culture and the Ukrainian language here in Ukraine on Ukrainian soil. The newspaper, The Ukrainian Word, was published. There was a literary supplement to this newspaper, which was later called Litavri. Later, she headed and edited this supplement. The publication Litavri, headed by Teliha, was reluctant to the German occupation authorities, but they exposed the crimes of the Russian Bolshevik regime against Ukraine. The best works of Ukrainian literature that distributed the ideas of Ukrainian independence and national unity were published here. In December 1941, employees of the newspaper The Ukrainian Word were arrested for patriotic pro-Ukrainian views. Olena Teliha also faced a similar threat. She was not only offered but ordered to leave Kyiv with her husband or to take illegal status, but she obstinately refused. Documents were issued for her and Mikhailo. It was necessary to leave Kyiv at the appointed time. She insisted, saying, "I have to stay here." Olena Teliha was arrested on February 9, 1942, and on February 21, together with other members and activists of the Organization of Ukrainian Nationalists, she was shot in Babi Yar on the outskirts of Kyiv at that time. Feeling her bitter fate, Olena Teliha once prophetically wrote, "In a web of crossed colors, I passionately dream until the morning that God sends me the greatest gift, hot death, but not winter dying." For Olena Teliha, as well as for many of her like-minded associates, the idea of the statehood of Ukraine was the main one both in poetry and in public activity. Devoting herself to this idea, she knew that she was on the path to her death, but at the same time, she was cheerful, optimistic, believed in victory, and believed in Ukraine. Only after the fall of the Soviet Empire, Ukrainians realized what category of outstanding personalities Olena Teliha truly belonged to.